Welcome to the ThinkCell Tutorials. The library gives you access to slide templates, icons, stock images, and your own slide and image assets, all directly within PowerPoint. With the library, you can quickly find slides and images from your computer or network to add to your presentation. Instead of digging through months or years' worth of files for that perfect slide or image, use the library to locate a particular asset in seconds. This video shows you how to search your slides and images in the library, and how to insert these assets in your presentations. To find out how to add your slide and image assets to the library, see our video tutorial. Let's say that sometime in the first quarter of 2024, a teammate made a slide about your company's brand position in Europe that would be perfect for a report that you're creating now. First, open the library. In the PowerPoint ribbon, go to the Insert tab and select Library. Select the folder that contains your assets and enter Europe in the search box. The search results include slides with text that contains your search term, and slides belonging to presentations that have the search term in their file name. To see the file name and slide number, hover over the thumbnail. To resize the slide thumbnails, hold Ctrl and rotate the mouse wheel to zoom in and out. On a touchpad, pinch and stretch. You can see results from the folder you've selected and all of its subfolders. By default, the library sorts your search results by location, so that PowerPoint files appear alphabetically by folder name and file name. You can also sort your results by most recent, so that files appear by last modified date from newest to oldest. You can also refine your results with filters. Since you're looking for a presentation from the first quarter of 2024, enter this date range in Date Modified. You can also filter your search results by Slide Aspect Ratio, Authors, Slide Masters, and Layouts. For example, it's easy to find the slide from your teammate when you select their name in Authors. In Aspect Ratio, Authors, Slide Masters, and Layouts, you can select multiple options. Just click to select or deselect an option. Once you've found the slide you need, you can choose where to insert the slide in your presentation. The slide will appear after your currently selected slide, or you can select the area between two slides where you want the new slide to appear. Click once on the slide thumbnail to insert it. The process for finding and inserting images is quite similar. Let's say that you want to find a map of Europe that shows where your company is active. You know that the file has the word map in its name, so just select your assets folder and enter map in the search box. You can now see all your files that have the word map in their file name. To see an image's file name, hover over its thumbnail. If you want to find maps in a specific folder, for example, the Investor Relations folder, just select it in the source list. If you want to open the folder where an image is located, let's say because you want to add, edit, or delete an image, just click the gray bar with the folder name. To see your changes to the folder in the library, press F5. Select the image you want to insert by clicking the thumbnail. Right now, Lock Positions by default is on, which means that you can either insert the image anywhere on the slide, or you can snap the orange frame to a suggested alignment with other ThinkCell elements. To align the map with the chart, snap the top of the orange frame to the top of the chart, then click to insert the map. Next, click and drag the white handle at the bottom of the map so that the map's bottom grid line snaps to the bottom of the chart. Finally, let ThinkCell adjust the selection frame. Click one of the locks on the vertical grid lines to open it. To position, resize, or crop an image, See our video on images and icons. And that's it for this tutorial on using your own assets with the library. You can also build presentations with other kinds of library content. For example, with the slide templates provided by ThinkCell, or with stock images and icons. To learn more, check out the links to our other library tutorials.